Hello, Mr. Stone here, and today we're going to be talking about Z distribution and Z scores. Our objective is to describe and apply the Z distribution and Z scores to a normal distribution. And we also have a little bit of homework. If you are in my class, we're looking at 24 C numbers 1 through 3 and number 5. So make a note of that, pause if you need to. Then when you've got that, let's carry on. Some of the big ideas is that knowing how many standard deviations a value is on a normal distribution curve is a very helpful thing. It's a way to compare different types of data that might not have the same mean or the same standard deviation. But if we can pull those out and we just look at standard deviations, that gives us an idea for how far something is away from the mean, which is incredibly useful. The Z distributions and Z scores can help us describe that data in terms of the standard deviations, and the Z scores can put a numerical value on that in terms of, really, again, it's just a measure of the distance of a value from the standard from the mean in terms of standard deviations. That is our unit of measurement. So let's take a look at what that looks like. So your normal distribution curve should be pretty familiar to you by now. It's not perfect, please forgive it, but hey, you know, I do the best that I can. With a normal distribution, we're used to seeing something like this. Here is our mu, there is our mean. Go down a wee bit over here, then you've got mu plus one standard deviation, you go a little bit further, mu plus two standard deviations, and we get the same thing kind of going this way. Pardon me if it's not totally complete here, but again, I'm not the greatest artist. I just want to show you what the awesome stuff with this is. So there is our normal distribution. What the z-score does is it allows us to talk about all this data, but without having to worry about an exact mean or an exact standard deviation. I could have data where the mean is equal to like 72 and the standard deviation is 9. I could also have a mean that is 149 and a standard deviation of 15.8, okay? Regardless of what these are, if we use a z-score, it is always going to be the same. We're going to use this formula down here. Your z is equal to your value x minus mu over sigma. I'm going to copy that down one more time just in case that's small, because I don't know what size device you're watching this on. Your z is equal to whatever value you have from your data minus the mean over your standard deviation. That's it. What does that do to this? Well, if we put the z-score for each one of these down here, if you take a value, and let's take mu. Mu, put it in for x, minus mu is 0. 0 divided by anything is going to be 0. That means your z-distribution, your mean is always 0. If I put in here the value for one standard deviation away, again, I'm going to see that this is going to become 1. This becomes 2. If I went further, I'd see 3. Over here, this becomes negative 1, negative 2. Okay, that's not like a negative 10. Let me make that a little bit smaller. These are all measures of how many standard deviations you are away from the mean. The mean is 0 standard deviations away, so it's 0. Mean plus one standard deviation, that has a z-score of 1. It is 1 standard deviation away. 2 standard deviations away. If I was in between here, I could put 1.5 standard deviations away. That would be the z-score. Okay? So your z-score is essentially how many standard deviations you are away from the mean. If it is positive, you are to the right of the mean. If it is negative, you are to the left of the mean. And this is true for all data that's under a normal distribution, regardless of what the actual mean or the standard deviation are. All right, so A data set has a mean of 27 and a standard deviation of 6. If we want to find the z-score of 19, simple. Z is equal to x minus mu over your standard deviation, which is equal to substitute your value, 19, minus 27, which is your mu. Okay, x minus mu over your standard deviation of 6. That is approximately negative 1.33. That's it. That is how you find the z-score. It is not terribly complicated. So, you give it a try. Now it's your turn. Take a look at these. Pause the video. And after you have calculated these, unpause it. You can go ahead, you can pause right now. I will wait here patiently. All right, are you back? Let's take a look at what these are. For number one, we should have had a z-score of 1.43. For number two, we should have had a z-score of 0.420. And for number three, we should have had a z-score of negative 0.752. That should be what we've got. I hope we can see that okay. Ish, right? We can see that okay-ish. All right. Now, what's useful about these z-scores? Well, as we said in the beginning, it's useful to compare different types of data. So let's look at an example. Lenny scored an 86 on a biology exam. The class mean was 81%, and they had a standard deviation of 5% on their scores. So this could be a little bit confusing. Think of these as points, okay? Think of them as points. Lenny scored a 76% on a history exam. The class mean was 71% and had a standard deviation of 3%. All right? Which course did Lenny do better than the average in? Now, it looks like he pretty much did the same in both. You've got a difference of 86% to 81%. He's 5 percentage points better than the mean here. He's 5 percentage points better than the mean here. But we're going to see that's not quite the case, because if we use our z-score formula, z is equal to your value x minus the mean over the standard deviation. Plug in here. In this case, our z for bio, I'll call it z sub b, is equal to 86, that's our value, minus the mean of 81 over 5, which gives us 5 over 5, which is equal to 1. He's 1 standard deviation, and it's positive, so he's to the right. He's basically 1 standard deviation better than the class mean, class average. Let's do z sub h for history. And their value is 76 for his score minus 71, which is the class mean, divided by the standard deviation of 3. Now, this gives us 5 over 3, which is, let's make that approximately 1.67. So he is almost 2 standard deviations better than the class mean. The smaller standard deviation here means that the data is a little bit more scrunched together. It's more closely distributed to the mean. So although the percentage might be the same in both, we can see that Lenny actually did better than the class average fairly significantly, compared to how he did to the average in biology. So it gives us another lens to look at this, and rather than just say, oh, he did 5% better in both, if we know the standard deviation, we can say, oh, he did almost two standard deviations better. I don't know, 1 2/3, which is close, round here in the middle. And it gives us another way to look at it, right? So that's the utility of the z-scores. They allow us to compare data that has different means, different standard deviations that we might not otherwise be able to compare. So let's take a look at one more that I'd like you guys to work on. Barry runs a short distance sprint and a long distance run. Here's the data for Barry. I'll read this out a little bit just in case it's hard to see on your screen. So he's running in two different runs, a sprint and a long distance run. In the sprint, his Barry's time is 42.3 seconds. The mean for the runners is 45.3 seconds, with a standard deviation of 5.4 seconds. For the long distance run, he runs 15.6 minutes for the race. The mean is 16.4 minutes, and the standard deviation is 1.1 minutes. Using Z-scores to determine which type of running, either the sprint or the long distance run, that Barry is better than the average at. And also why. And we should be able to explain that with Z-scores. One other thing to think about for this problem, when you are running a race, do you generally want to have a shorter time or a longer time? This one's a little bit different than what we looked at a moment ago, but I want you to think about that so you can really interpret what is better in this case. Is it having that shorter time or longer time, and what that's going to look in the normal distribution? Practice that, ask me any questions that you have, and enjoy learning about Z-scores.